Section this finished last week about remember I have two parts of the Om, which are first section has two parts, which number one which are striving for purity in the actions of three doors of expression and protecting one step from slipping. The first have three divisions. How to watch one's physical and verbal behavior, and how to watch one's own mind, and then explanation of the situation which are about and those which are not. Then watching one's physical and verbal behavior will be presented in terms of examining one's own motivation prior to any physical action, advice concerning how to look around and other subjects, applying the advice to other activities, and then finally watching how one is staying. And then here is the first one. We finish this about whenever one is about to go somewhere or do anything of the kind, one should have a particular moment. That is, before anything else, examine one's motivation. One should decide this state of mind has something wrong with it, or the state of mind has nothing wrong with it. So checking your motivation. If that point you find that your motivation does not have something wrong with it, then you should apply the appropriate antidote, which is to freeze exactly as you are, like a bum on the lock, and refuse to be moved by something which is not good. So we finish this one. Then advice relating to how one should look around comes in the separate steps. General presentation on how you should undertake activities of your eyes to look around. So when we are looking, so we also look with mindfulness, consciousness, and with using these three most important tools, you know, alertness, mindfulness, and consciousness. When you look, or when you looking around, then all activities turn into the virtuous, positive. And then instruction on what you do if become tired, what to do if someone approach you, and what to do when you have finished refreshing yourself. So the first one, I should never at any time look around from side to side, meaningless, with my mind distracted. So when you're looking without distracted, you're looking with the mindfulness. You're looking, whatever you look, with the mindfulness. Whatever you talk with the mindfulness, whatever you, before you study your actions of the body and speech, so checking your motivation and making sure your physical activities and verbal activities are not harming others, you know, not influenced by the afflictive emotions, the disturbing emotions. Then when you realize, oh, my motivation is not going to that direction, so no need to apply antidote. So then whatever you do is meaningful. Here's the thing. If the time should come to invigorate, I-N-V-I-G-O-R-A-T-E. This kind of layer.
In what?
I-N. Pronunciation problem. I-N. V-I-G-O-R-A-T. This is not like...
Figure
it. Huh? I'll go to the dictionary here.
Invigorate.
Okay,
don't need to
My teacher here.
Technology.
Teacher in the computer.
Yes, Peter.
Okay, so. Then if I find that I have become tired looking this anyway, then to refresh myself, I should for the time being raise my eyes and look around this image. Then here's the point, all this image as well. So here's the fourth, how to stay in different states. So that means that whenever I'm engaged in anything at all, I should consider myself, prepare myself, and say this is how my body is engaged right now in this image. Okay, so sorry, I do find this. So now we are here, I think, verse 48. Whenever there is attachment in my mind, and whenever there is the desire to be angry, I should not do anything, no say anything, but remain like a piece of wood. So that means, I want to explain this one. It's kind of like meditation, you know. So mind, remember, because when your mind is polluted by these negative emotions, afflictive emotions, then you have to do two things: analytical meditation and the single-pointed meditation. So analytical meditation can help you to, when you analyze, then this will help you to subdue your mind. So you're using, you know, using logics, and you're using all these, you know, reasons. And by analyzing, you will be able to stabilize your mind, and mind become more calm, stable, you know. So this is like, so here, this Indian master, you know, Dharmakirti said, mind his capacity to grow endless and limitless. Mind, you know, our mind has capacity to develop endless, limitless. It's not like, he said, it's not like jumping in boiling water, you know. So, because jumping is kind of like, you can jump 1-2 yards by training, getting better and better, but there's a point, you cannot go beyond that one. And also the boiling water, you know. When you boil the water, you know, and then boiling, but eventually, if you boil, it will dry. But mind, the capacity of mind is totally over there of jumping and, you know, jumping and like boiling the water. Because mind have capacity, if our mind used with this two meditation, you know, steady, you know, compassion mind, base is very firm. Foundation is very good, and not depending on the your effort is already there, you know, base, very good. It is quality of the mind, you know, it is quality of the mind. If, when we talk about the quality of the mind, you know, the quality of the mind, compassion mind, Bodhisattva mind, these are foundation, very, very solid, very, very good. You don't have to put any effort, it is already there, you know. It's, the beauty is already there. So if you go use these two types of meditation with the right motivation, then this will help you to change your ordinary mind, you know, ordinary mind. So this he gave example like, he gave first example of the negative feeling, you know. Negative feeling if you have like concentrating on the negative, you know. For example, like if you say, you may concentrating on very attractive object, and you may say, oh, beautiful, beautiful, like that, you know. You may concentrating on the very negative, like enemy, you know, bad, bad, bad. But this will not increase your emotion, you know. So for example, he used like this, oh, first, oh, you have, you may develop attachment to the attractive object, he or she. And then you use analytical reason, he or she, you know, done this very good, and then your feeling increase. And then, I like this person, I'll, you know, make more beauty. And then, eventually, using all this analytical meditation, your emotion will increase, right? If you say beauty, beauty, it will not increase emotion. If you say bad, 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 enemy, that will not increase you. But if you use like that, right? For example, are you using enemy or she, he or she is my enemy. So he did this in the past, and hurting me, annoying me, will annoy in the future. You're using all this, not only me, maybe my relatives will keep going like this, thinking, will analyze, right? And then you're feeling, but even this enemy is not around too far, you know, but it, with this analytical thinking will annoy your mind, disturb your mind, right? So you may change your face, you know, change your color of the face, and you may be very angry, but person not close to you, but thinking this analytical will analyze. And then you also exaggerate, you know, all this enemy, my enemy, my enemy, using all this analytical meditation, and then you designate it enemy, right? And then all, even though it is not correct, enemy have some qualities, but you will surpass all these qualities by this negative feeling. And then you concentrate, this is kind of the you, how emotion increase, thinking like this, and then you concentrate, oh, I don't like this person, 100% my enemy, you know, single point of concentration. So this is kind of like, if we change this to other, you know, if we change that to the virtuous object, then completely different, you know. So it's kind of like, he said here, the term of meditation, you know, change that attitude to the virtuous object. So make your mind accustomed to, or take on the stage of the object of meditation. So here, if you switch off this and go direction of the virtuous object, right? So meditation, so he said, meditation is kind of like, if you're meditating on the compassion and the faith for the Bodhisattva mind, so it means one part of your mind transformed to that compassion and loving kindness and bodhicitta mind, right? Not like subject and object. You're meditating, usually meditating on the compassion, faith, loving kindness is kind of like more on the single point. It means transform your mind, one part of your mind, transform into the compassion, like. And then meditation on, for example, like emptiness, Four Noble Truths, impermanence. It's not like transforming your mind to the emptiness. When you are meditating on the Four Noble Truths, not transforming your mind to the truth of suffering, to the origin of suffering, right? So it's like subject-object mind, right? So meditation on emptiness, it's try to making your mind more in mindfulness of this object, right? So subject-object. So, and so this means, so when we use, so here Lama Tsongkhapa gives very, very good example, and we, there is no contradiction between analytical meditation and the single point meditation. We must combine this meditation, whatever we do, you know. First analytical meditation, and then single point. That this analytical meditation is very, very good to increase your wisdom, you know. Analytical meditation. So whatever we done, first analytical meditation and then single-pointed concentration. So there's no contradiction. We cannot use at the same time, but, you know, when you are meditating the single-pointed concentration, you can't use analytical meditation, right? But we need both single-pointed and analytical meditation. So no contradiction, right? We need, both are very useful. So here, you know, Lama Tsongkhapa gave a very good example of like, when you find the, you know, gold under the ground, right? Gold under the ground. So you find the gold under the ground, first you need to burn the gold, then you wash away the impurities of the gold. And then after this, it is suitable to make any kind of ornament, you know, like earring or whatever, you know. So when you take gold under the ground, what you need is first you burn the gold, then you wash away all the impurities of the gold, and then it is very suitable to make any kind of ornament. So similarly, when we start meditation, right, very similar, like burning, first we need to burn the gold, right? So these impurities influence our body, speech and mind. So these impurities are just like, we need to burn these impurities like gold burn in the fire. So these impurities, here we can say the impurities of the affective emotions, you know, three poisons, will bring all this pain, suffering, unwanted happiness, everything, you know, because of this impurity. So what we need to do is, we need first transform our mind into renunciation, you know. It's just like burning gold in the fire. So renunciation means thinking, you know, now you're thinking this, you know, samsara, you know, samsara. So here is the one beautiful poem by the great one Tibetan master. You know. So you can see how important to practice renunciation. The great Tibetan master said, and comfort forever, but you are certain to lose them. You would like to keep, you know, the excellent human life with the freedom and advantage forever, but you are certain to die. You would like to study Dharma with your wonderful teacher forever, but you are certain to part. You would like to be with your good spiritual friends forever, but you are certain to separate. Oh, my friends, who feel deep disillusionment with samsara, I, the Dharmaless Baker, exhort you from today, put on the armor of effort. From the time has come to the cross, the land of great bliss, where there is no separation. So this is the, they are talking about, when you practice Dharma, there is no separation, you know. Dharma is kind of like, if you practice, you know, whatever happened to us, right? Happiness, health, possession, happiness, all come from our actions, right? It is a result of our actions. So if you really practice Dharma, there's no separation, you know. When you are not practicing, you know, then there's separation. Renunciation is the kind of like, not renouncing, you know. So it's like mixing your practice with the inwardly Dharma, you know, it's kind of like, it's polluted. So it's like mind is polluted with this inwardly Dharma. So when the mind is pure, there's no separation, you know. So it's kind of like you're practicing, Dharma. It is your company, you know, it will go forever, you know, until you achieve enlightenment. The company practice spiritual is continuation, not like separating our body and mind. So if spiritual practice, and if you practice pure Dharma, you know, there's no separation with your teacher, no separation with the Buddha. Buddha is within insight. So the renunciation, right? Renouncing, thinking the nature of the samsara, you know, renunciation. And thinking about the nature of the Four Noble, nature of the Truth of Suffering. Thinking impermanence will transform your mind into the renouncing mind. So then this kind of analytical meditation is like burning this gold. You burn your impurities, you know, now polluted mind burn, right? So when this finish, then next, go to now, because you already burn your impurities, mind will turn into the joy with the happiness. With this analytical meditation, then you can meditate on the advantage of the relying on the spiritual masters, advantage of the practicing law of causality, karma, advantage of the practicing Bodhisattva mind. So because mind, so that impurity burned, now mind turned into the joy virtues, you know, joy virtues. So you can take seeing all this advantage of practicing Dharma. So there's this kind of advantage of practicing Dharma and thinking the advantage of the, you know, three jewels, you know, like spiritual masters and Bodhisattva mind, then this kind of analytical meditation, you know. Then after this, if this is kind of like washing your, this gold, wash your, after burn, then you wash away with the waters. So all your spiritual practice moistened with this rituals. Just like this, washing this gold with the water. And then, this, when you burn the gold and then clean by the water, then because of this meditation, the analytical meditation, then your mind become more stabilized. So the analytical meditation is key factor to settle your mind. Analytical meditation is most important to making your mind more calm and peace. So without analytical meditation, you won't be able to success your practice in meditation. So therefore, some masters, there are different. Some says, analytical is not necessarily analytical meditation. Like Chinese, Hashan, Chinese master, came to Tibet, and his view is just single-pointed, push away all the thought, nothing, just push the thought, remain calm. Many Tibetan like this, but Kamala Shila came to Tibet, and these both are very important. So that means, mind is a quality of the mind is very, very, if you use and go to the right direction, it will go farther and farther, not like jumping and not like boiling the water. So that's a very important meditation. Whenever I have distracted thought, I wish to verbally belittle others, feeling of self-importance and self-satisfaction. When I have intention to describe the faults of others, pretension, and thought to deceive others. So it means whenever your mind distracted thought, the mind is not. If you are meditating, if you are meditating on meditation, is kind of like cultivating, cultivating. Like, so we, say cultivate will lead you to the path to meditation, right? The path to meditation will lead you to the path of seeing. You see the object reality clearly. Whatever you meditate, right? So you need first familiar with the meditation object again and again, right? So then this will lead you to the path to meditation, right? The meditation, then you will be able to see the path of seeing. See object directly. See object directly means without using any thought, just non-conceptual mind, isn't it? So it's just like spontaneous. It's just like when you talk about, like, it's just like somebody, if you do, somebody memorize the text, right? Recitation is spontaneous. Just whenever you talk about whatever you're meditating, when you somebody mention about this, your meditation object, it will come to your mind spontaneous. Just like recitation of the prayer. So people who memorize, recite the prayer at the same time, doing other things. The recitation is spontaneous. So similar meditation is kind of like this, spontaneous. So when the mind is distracted, then we're not meditating, right? So whenever we meditate, making sure your mind remains in the meditation object. Your body is meditating with the posture, right? If your mind go outside, then your body is meditating, your mind is not meditating. So your body remains meditation, but your mind not meditating, right? So it means we should, during meditation time, any meditation we need to use, analyze the subject, So, right? So, because this wild mind is not easy to subdue, you know. So it is kind of like our meditation is gradual, you know, steady, you know. It's step by step, you know. It's very important, not like expecting very quick result. But you can see when you look, if you change your action, then your practice is working. If you, it means all the Buddha's teaching, you know, Buddha taught 84,000 teachings, all come to one point, is you have to know who you are, you know, exactly, you know. You have to know your nature of the mind. That is all 84,000 teachings come to one point, is knowing yourself, knowing your mind, knowing your, we call this self-liberation, you know, self-liberation. Knowing your nature of the mind, knowing, remember I mentioned about dharmakaya, you know, dharmakaya is emptiness of the mind, no separation, you know. So all these emotions are inseparable with dharmakaya. They are the manifestation. So when you know how to do this, right, negative thought, positive thought, not different, all transform into your meditation practice. Especially, you know, so this is very important, you know, when we do purification, we can't see, you know, right? It's not like external object. If somebody, this is many great masters said, if, you know, somebody makes you angry, right? Anger, you know? If you practice 1 second of the patience, will be best purification, you know? Really, really, better than reciting mantra, you know? And maybe, you may reciting mantra, maybe, who knows? Mind will distract it. Mind goes everywhere. Recitation is not very effective, you know. Even you recite millions of mantra, but you still remain the same person. But if there's opportunity, you know, then you take this opportunity. 1 second, 1 minute, this is really, really effective. So it's kind of like hard to believe, you know, we're not seeing this. These are the qualities of the mind. So the qualities of the mind are carried by the, you know, seed. These seed are what we call the, usually we call these are like not manifesting phenomena for us. You know. Manifesting phenomena, our manifesting phenomena is see, hear, smell, taste. Whatever gross mind see is manifesting, you know. Whatever subtle object is not manifesting for us, you know. For example, like if I said, remember there's three types of, you know, phenomena, right? We have manifesting phenomena, right? Hidden phenomena, extremely hidden phenomena. These are hidden phenomena, you know. Carrying your seed is hidden phenomena for us, because hidden phenomena, extremely hidden phenomena. Right? So hidden phenomena is kind of like Buddha said. If Buddha said, "Oh, giving generosity will receive you wealth in the future," but you can't see this, you know. These are hidden phenomena, you know? But we will trust the Buddha, you know. Buddha is valid person. He is valid because completely purified mind, isn't it? No obscuration, omniscient mind, you know, Buddha's mind, and he will never tell liars. Therefore, if you are Buddhist, Buddha kind of like hidden phenomena like that, we are relying on the authentic person. Our authentic person is Buddha, you know. Buddha said, giving generosity will receive you well. practicing morality will receive you this precious human rebirth in the future, you know. He said. But these are hidden phenomena. Oh, difficult to believe. This is what difficult to believe and manifesting to our mind. So therefore, so this is kind of like, so my point is, so when you are meditating, isn't it? Meditating. It is very important to meditate without distracted. It is very important to be good quality of the meditation, you know. Quality very good, you know. You don't have to meditate for 10, 20 minutes, but very short meditation can be very good meditation, refreshing your mind, you know. It means, number one, you need intention. Intention, whatever you're meditating, you have intention, right? Without intention, there's no impossible, right? Set of intention. Intention will influence your mind. Influencing your mind by intention. So when the intention influences your mind, and then the question, how long I will meditate on this particular object? Oh, I can do this meditation for 10 minutes. Okay, I'm meditating on the 10 minutes. When the 10 minutes finish, very good, right? So you set up intention. Intention will influence your mind, and then you ask the question, oh, I will meditate on 10 minutes. So you're concentrating 10 minutes, and then you finish, right, your meditation section. With the joyfully, you know, with the happily, joyfully, then this will recharge your meditation all the time. You want to meditate again and again, you know. You know what I mean? Oh, whenever, today I did this, tomorrow I want to do this again and again. So if you go like that for 1 week, 2 weeks, it will recharge your mind, refresh your mind. Then you want to do more and more meditation. Then you will extend your meditation. So it should be goal like that, isn't it? So not necessarily you have to be, you know, staying long time on the meditation cushion. So if you are busy, you know, like in the West, everyone is busy, you know, no time. So refresh your mind, set up intention, finish with joyfully, and dedicate all these good qualities. You want to do this again and again, you know, really. It's kind of like, whenever somebody talks about meditation, it's kind of like joy, you know. It's spontaneous. It is a joy. It's kind of like, you know, if you think, you know, really, really feel fortunate to meet Dharma in the West, you know what I mean, very, very fortunate. So you have to utilize this. And don't think it's just like, you know, same, you know, just like tradition, not like that. Like, have to be very, very fortunate. These are very useful for, you know, useful for your life, right? You have less problem, you know. And I can see, you know, whenever you meditate and you change yourself, you know, different person. You know what I mean? So it's so often you have to think, oh, I'm very, very fortunate. Especially I have, you know, such a wonderful teaching from the great master. You know, we don't have power, but we have such, you know, receiving all this, you know, from the many great master, you know. Tibetan Buddhist lineage is very, very important, you know. Lineage is kind of like blessing. It's kind of like two hands, you know. You can't achieve the realization without lineage, without blessing of the, you know, guru master, you know. This guru is the foundation of all the... If you have guru, right, is the foundation of your spiritual development. If you think realization, so we have expression in Tibet, if you think, if you believe guru is like Buddha, you will receive the blessing of the Buddha. If you believe Guru is Bodhisattva, you will receive the blessing from Bodhisattva. If you believe Guru is some holy spiritual, you will receive the blessing from the spiritual, holy spiritual. But if you believe Guru is ordinary, you will never receive any blessing. You know, this is expression in Tibet. So it depends on the faith, right? Faith is very important. If you have faith, everything will come to you naturally. Your practice will be natural. Your realization is natural because of developing faith. We're not talking about blind faith, right? We are talking about faith which is based on the wisdom. You analyze, right? So you analyze the teaching, right? Buddha himself said, don't follow me because you respect for me, right? Buddha himself said, you know, don't follow me because you respect for me. You analyze my teaching. And if this is suitable, then you should practice like goldsmith, burning like that, right? So similarly, when we talk about every time we meditate, right? You should always think, I need help from the spiritual master, you know, lineage. Always keep, you know, keep in your mind. With the combination, I will guarantee you, you will achieve realization. This is not for me, all the, in the scripture, you know, like all the texts, all the, you know, masters always mentioning, you know, how important foundation of your realization is Guru, you know. Guru is Sanskrit word, is very heavy word, you know. When you accept Guru, very, very heavy, you know. It depends on you, whether you accept this person is your Guru or not. Once you accept it, then very, very heavy, you know. If you've done something good, good, bad, it's just heavy, that's the kind of heavy. Advantage, you can receive infinite advantage from the relying on the spiritual master. But disadvantage, so it's kind of like these, so meditation, always think about, so whenever you have difficulty, you know, then you have to think, I need to receive from the lineage blessing. And then very, very good work. Even if the three realms were offered, it will be insufficient in paying veneration to those few things in whom mere share of the good qualities of the unique assembly of the excellence appear. Then, since sentient beings have share in giving rise to the supreme Buddha qualities, surely in it correct to venerate them, and they are similar in merely this request.
Which one?
Oh, sorry, what, this one?
Yeah, the one back.
Page, this one, for...
What page is it?
Okay, so 51, sorry. Whenever I desire material gain, honor or fame, whenever I seek attendant or the circle of friends, and when my mind I wish to be served, and all this time I should remain like a peace. Inwardly Dhamma, okay, right? And whenever I have the wish to decrease or restore working for others, and the desire to pursue my welfare alone, if motivated by such thought and wish to say something occur, at this time I should remain like a piece of wood. So it means like when you are encountering with the people, very difficulties, you know, maybe sometimes you may discourage. You may think, you know, oh, I can't practice this precious Bodhisattva mind. You can see, you can meeting with people. People have different mental attitudes, and sometimes very difficult, you know. And during that period, you may lose your this precious mind. Remember, if you take the Buddhist well, you know, then or you think, oh, I can't practice this, it's difficult, then this will lose your this precious mind. So what you afflict your mind with thinking, you know, self-confidence, you know, looking, maybe you look some great masters and reading the biography of the great masters. And like looking some people who do good things, you know, like His Holiness and the Dalai Lama. It's very difficult like this. They are constantly, you know, doing good things, you know, many, many. So you uplift your mind. So whenever I have impatient and laziness, cowardice, and shamelessness, or the desire to talk nonsense. If thought of partiality arise, all this remain too, I should remain like peace. Partiality arise means, so you are, you know, not mind, not going to equanimity, right? So when we are meditating on the bodhicitta, then number one is equalizing our mind. It's kind of like fertilizing your soil, you know, making soil, and then you plant the seed, right? So equalizing, making soil more soft, more gentle, and then you plant the seed. Seed will grow with the moisture. So moistures are like compassion and loving kind are like moisture. So first you need equalizing your mind. So if there's a danger, you know, so enemy, stranger, and friends, so difficult to feeling. So this will be difficult. You have an enemy. When you meditate on an enemy, you know, then impatient, right? Instead of thinking equanimity, maybe you may develop anger towards the enemy. So it means during that period we need to think about equanimity, equalizing the mind. Equalizing the mind is kind of like, this is very good master saying, you may visualize three persons, right? Enemy, stranger, and friends. So when you look enemy, strangers, and three different kinds of feeling. When there are three different kinds of feeling, but if you analyze, like analytical meditation, it means enemy is not 100% enemy, you know. It will change to the friend. Friend is not 100% friend, it will change to the enemy. Stranger can be enemy, stranger can be friend. So there's no guarantee, you know. So when this analytical, this kind of meditation or analytical meditation will be help you to equalize your mind using, you know, no 100% enemy, no 100% friends, no 100% stranger, you know. All our nature of impermanence will change and we'll never know what happened, what will happen in the future, even. So this thinking, this will make your mind more equanimity, no bodhicitta mind, right? Bodhicitta mind is number one, equanimity, right? Equanimity is kind of like good soil fertilizing. Then moisture is like compassion, loving kind, they are like moisture. And then this will develop your mind. So this is like, this Dharmakirti, they said, the foundation of compassion is solid, no need effort, it's already there, it is quality of the mind. All moisture, water, sunlight, tree grow, right? But not only tree, giving you so many branches. giving you many branches, giving you many fruits, then person will enjoy the fruit. So similar, like that, right? So economy, fertilizing this soil, and then seed of compassion, moisture by loving kindness, this meditation will bring you enlightenment, will bring you to subdue this self-judging mind and grasping mind. When there's no self-judging, grasping mind, then we see our mind, because we are not seeing our mind. Okay, thank you.